What's up, guys? Matt Day here, and today we're going to be taking some photos in this building downtown Chillicothe, Ohio. This was an old bank building on the main floor, and these upper levels were some old office spaces. I've been doing some work with a local realtor as she's been kind of changing some of these old historic buildings downtown and going to be basically bringing them up to do some like new apartment spaces, new office spaces. And once we were filming in here the other day to talk about the space, I thought it would be awesome to just be able to walk around here, take some photos, and I asked her if I could also make a video out of it, and she said that would be great. So today we're just gonna be walking around, seeing what we can find and try to make some photos. Before we start walking around though, I'm gonna take a quick second to thank our sponsor for the day, which is Squarespace. So if you need a website, a domain, or an online store, make your next move with Squarespace. I've been using Squarespace for years. It's super easy to build a great website. And if you want to try it out and get 10% off your first purchase, go to squarespace.com/mattday. So I figure first thing we'll do is I'll talk about the cameras I brought, since I'm sure that's what a lot of people are interested in. I brought two cameras with me today. I have 135 and one medium format. Pentax K1000. This is a camera I've been using a lot lately, mainly because of this lens. I have the 28mm f2.8 lens, which is right here. Shooting 28 has been a lot of fun. I've really used this a lot at home with the kids because you can focus super close with this lens, and just that wide field of view, getting in really close, kind of like on their level. It's been a lot of fun, but I'll probably end up shooting some of that today. And I also have a 50mm f2. That's loaded up with HP5 right now, and I'm actually shooting that at box speed at the moment. And then I also brought the Hasselblad 500cm. I've got the 80mm f2.8 lens here. And right now this is also loaded up with Ilford HP5, but we're probably going to be pushing it depending on the different lighting scenarios. Some rooms like this, it's nice and bright, but other rooms, it's definitely not. So we'll see what we end up pushing this to. But after I shoot this roll, I'm also going to be shooting some color, some Portra 400. So I'm excited to see how that goes. Let's just see what the light is doing here. So ISO 1600, if I push this two stops, we'd be at f2.8. At 1000, which this only goes up to 500, so we'd be at f4 at 500. But I'd probably stop the lens down to like f8. So right now I think 1600 would be fine. So I think that's what we're gonna do. I usually push to 1600, so we'll just stick with that today. 1600, f8, 1/25th of a second. All right, so right now, as I'm looking through here and I'm framing everything up, I can see that we've got this one piece of shelf leaning against the window, and that's gonna bug me. So I'm actually gonna go move that because it doesn't really fit with this photo. One, compositionally, I don't like the way it's leaning against the window there, but also it's just plain shelving and it doesn't really fit with these old filing cabinets, so I'm gonna go ahead and take that out. Move these out of the way. And that, already, that looks a lot better. I like all the old filing cabinets stacked up over here, but that wasn't adding anything to the photo at all. It didn't really fit in with the photo. So I'm okay with moving that. Right there. There we go. At first I wasn't really seeing anything, it was kind of boring, but coming over here, I like this kind of stuff in the shot, in the foreground, and it's kind of like leading in. I'm getting some nice lines to the filing cabinets using the window pane here, and also this old heater. So we'll see what we can come up with here. Let's see, right there. So I want to shoot a photo in here. I want to shoot kind of through this hallway right here where you can see some of these doors and you can also see the window in the background. What I want to talk about real quick before I shoot this, or as I'm shooting it, is how I'm metering something like this, because regardless of how much light is in the scene, right now it's, you know, pretty bright. We have some decent light coming in. But the main thing is just that it's very directional. All of the light is coming from this direction here, and I'm going to be shooting in that direction. So a lot of people want to know, how they would meter something like that. Do you always meter towards the camera? Do you meter always towards the light? It really depends on what kind of look you're going for. So if I were to meter this with the bulb, the meter, facing the camera where I'm gonna be shooting, I'm getting a reading of f4 at a 30th of a second. If I meter towards the light, I'm getting f4 at 250th of a second. So obviously very, very different exposures. If I were to meter just like this, side to side should be, f4, 125th of a second. If I meter the same direction but further back, it's f4 at 60th of a second. So where your meter is placed is gonna give you very different results, obviously. And if you're in a situation like this, you can just walk around with your meter and try different things out and just kinda get a feel for it. The way I wanna expose for it, I'm gonna basically try and line my shot up so that you're gonna get a really nice highlight on these doors. If I were to shoot it this way, I'm not seeing any kind of highlight facing the door like this. If I'm shooting at more of an angle and I'm really catching the light sliding against the door, then I'm gonna see a nice highlight there. And for a black and white photo, those kind of highlights and shadows, that's the kind of stuff that I really wanna see. That's the kind of stuff that works really well for black and white. So I'm gonna meter this as if I was basically shooting out here. So f4, 125th of a second, and I'm gonna shoot back here. If I metered for all the way back here, it would really brighten everything up, and that's just not the look I'm going for. So right here, f4, 125th of a second, and let's see how that looks. So the way I'm framing this up, I like seeing the two doors lining up next to each other. I like that you can see the old font on the window where it says ladies closet. But I wanna shoot something like this, not only just for the light and things like that, but I'm really trying to shoot things that are gonna show the time of the building itself. It's gonna be going through a lot of changes. That's kind of been part of my job working with the local realtor is just kind of documenting the change as it's happening. But this is more just for my own taste, but I like shooting photos that really kind of show the time itself. So just seeing like the old windows in the doorway, the old lettering on the doors, that kind of stuff. That's the kind of stuff I'm really drawn to shooting. So right here, I'm just trying to line up the shot how I want it. Again, I want to make sure that shooting in this direction, I get that nice highlight on the second door back there. So I think right here, we should be good. Awesome. So using a waist level finder, I especially when shooting 6x6, I'm always trying to get things nice and lined up just right and really symmetrical. And on this particular shot, I was kind of down pretty low shooting up, so a lot of my lines were skewed a little bit. And for some photos, it really bothers me, but I think for this one, I actually kind of like the way that looked. So that's another thing. It just really comes down to personal preference and comes down to the photo altogether. I think setting too many rules for yourself sometimes can be a little restrictive. So just have fun with it. So as we're kind of walking around this space, I happened to be looking through the hallway and I saw a photo shooting through the doorway. And then I walked in here to meter and I realized this is the room I was already in before. But shooting from a little bit further distance and outside the room and seeing more of it, now I see a totally different photo than I saw from whenever I was just standing right here. So always be sure to kind of walk around and look at things from different angles, because now I see something totally different. For this, I'm gonna meter probably pretty close to the window. I'm gonna be down in the hallway where it's darker. So out here, I'm totally fine with exposing more for this area and having the foreground be pretty dark. I think it's gonna just help lead into the area of focus where there's gonna be a lot more light. So for this, just like earlier, f8, 125th of a second, I'll probably open the lens up though, f4 at 500th of a second. Right there. Try and line this up just right. Right there's perfect. So now the sun is moving, and luckily we've got all these big windows, so when the sun really comes out, we can start seeing a lot more light and shadows throughout the place. And right here, we've got these two windows and these two rooms side by side, and it's casting just about the exact same shadow in the two rooms, and we have this nice doorway to see both. So I'm going to try and line these up and hopefully make something good out of it. The shadow on this window is kind of lining up with the middle shadow on the room back there. So this is really kind of cool. All right. So we're in this tiny bathroom here, and I was trying to shoot a photo with the Hasselblad, and I really couldn't find any kind of composition I liked. It just felt way too tight. With the 80 millimeter lens, it's a lot more like a 50 millimeter equivalent, and it was pretty tight and cramped in here. So I grabbed the Pentax, and I've got the 28 millimeter lens on here, and now it looks entirely different, just the space as a whole, and especially not only that being a wider lens, but going from 6x6, a square format, to 35 millimeter frame, it's definitely changing things up a lot. So let's see, right now I just want to shoot a photo of this sink right here and kind of straight into this corner. So we're at f8, 30th of a second. I'm not too worried about shooting handheld 30th of a second, considering I've got a 28 millimeter lens. You can shoot pretty slow with a wide lens like that. And actually, I want to shoot some detail kind of stuff here on this sink because it's disgusting. And I'm going to switch to the 50 millimeter for that. So I want to get a photo in this corner here, and just noticing with the window right there, all the light coming in this way, just moving the door back and forth, I can really kind of change and see exactly how I want the light to be on the door. And also, we've got this crazy cracked window here, and ideally I'd like to be able to see right through it if there were more light behind it back there. Only problem with that is moving the door, it kind of turns off or shuts off any of the light hitting back there. So I kind of have to play around with it a little bit, but see what I can come up with. Let's see. Yeah, we're at f2.8 at 1/25th of a second, so. See, with a wide lens like this, I'm crouching down and getting kind of further back, and I'm getting this creeping into the shot, but I actually kind of like this curve right here. It kind of works with the composition. Right there, we'll try this. So I'm at 1/25th of a second, 2.8. Let's give it a shot. This kind of thing though, it works really well shooting 6x6 with the two windows there, the chair right in the center. If I can frame this upright, I'll be pretty happy. Trying to get the right height. This goes back to what I was talking about earlier with how you're pointing the camera and at what height and how you're lining everything up. Right here. Especially handheld. So for this, I don't really want to focus necessarily on the light that's coming into the window since I'm not up close and really kind of going for that look. I want a little bit more of a brighter kind of exposure, just kind of showing off the whole space. So for this, I'm at f16, 1/15th of a second. So I got out the cable release and I'm gonna use the mirror lockup. This is just gonna basically prevent the camera from shaking during the exposure from the shutter. So the shutter, the mirror will flip up, and then I've got the cable release to manually fire the shutter after that. So got everything set up here. So the mirror is now up and now I took the photo. So that just comes into handy whenever you're shooting something like this. If you're shooting a slower shutter speed, trying to do it with your actual hand on the camera, sometimes that works, but if you've got a cable release, it's, you know, just another good kind of precaution to take, so that way you don't get any kind of motion blur. And that finishes off this roll. So that one's all done. There we go. HP5 pushed to 1600. Now it's time to load up some color. So next, we're gonna load up some Portra 400. And in here, I'm definitely gonna be using the tripod and the cable release, just because with this film, I'm not rating it at 1600 like I would the black and white film. For a film like this, Portra 400, I usually rate at 200 just to give me a little bit more exposure. Portra 400 can handle a ton of overexposure, so it's always good to err on the side of overexposure versus underexposure. And I'll be metering for the shadows as well, so my exposure times are going to be drastically different shooting this film than they were whenever I was shooting HP5. So load it up and we're about ready to go. Do that first. There we go. Load it up. So I got Portra 400 loaded up in here. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot one more photo up here before we move, just because I shot the same scene on HP5, so I kinda wanna just have both shots just to compare. But I was shooting HP5 at 1600, and that was giving me f16 at 1/15 of a second. Now I'm gonna be shooting Kodak Portra 400, which I'm rating at 200 just to give me a little bit more exposure. So that's a 3-stop difference. So instead of f16 at 1/15, now we're at f16 at 1/2 a second. So got it set up here. I'm gonna go ahead and flip the mirror up, and now we'll go ahead and take the shot. 1/2 second, there we go. With this one here, I'm focused on this doorknob and it's pretty dim in this area, so it looks like I'm in focus, but this focusing screen is pretty poor. So we'll see. I'm at f4, 1 second, and same thing, flip the mirror up, and now there's the shot. Probably meter kind of in the shadows here. So that's f4 at 1/2 a second. Out here, f4 at 1/15. So yeah, probably do f4 at f4 at 1/4 of a second maybe. Everything in this place is brown. Something about that time period where everything was just brown. So, right there, we're going to do the same exposure. Take that down. So scene like this, obviously if I meter to the window, it's going to give me a 1/30 of a second, f5.6. If I'm metering away from it, it's giving me a 1/2 a second, 5.6. So I'm probably going to shoot this at f8, and I will do 1 second, and we'll see how that looks. We'll probably bracket this one as well. So I'll do a couple different exposures, but let's start with f8 at 1 second. Right there. And across the street is the courthouse, and there are people coming in and out. I want to try and wait until there's nobody in the shot and also no vehicles on the street that I can see, just to kind of eliminate any kind of, I guess, distraction or anything that just doesn't seem to fit. Okay, that's better. So now flip the mirror up. Right now, 1 second. Good. No traffic, no people came out at that time. I'm not sure how much detail we're going to have out there in the windows. Let's shoot a couple. So let's do, that was F8 at 1 second. Let's do F5.6 at 1 second. There's a guy in a nice brown suit walking into the courthouse. Let's wait until he's passed. There we go. All right, let's try this again. Let's do F8 at 1 second again. So with the last couple frames, I shot some portraits of Levi, who's behind the camera. Huge thanks to him for doing this today. It's been nice to be able to get out of my office for once and actually make some videos. So this is going to be hopefully something we can regularly do. But yeah, that's the end of this roll. So all the film that I shot today, this stuff here, this is going off to the Find Lab to be developed and scanned. So all the photos you've seen, that was all done by the Find Lab. Any adjustments I might have made as well, I'll probably do a follow-up video on that, just showing how I edit the scans that I get back from the lab. But also, the film that I shot earlier, the Ilford HP5, that was all developed and scanned at home. I'm developing with Ilfatech HC, like I always do. If you want to see anything about that, I've got a video breaking down all the chemicals and the whole process as well. So if you guys have any questions about any of this stuff, feel free to leave those in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this kind of video. It's very different from what I've been doing in the past, but again, it's something I've been wanting to do. It's just a matter of finding somebody who can actually do this. So now that I've got Levi on board, hopefully we can do this more often, because I have a lot more fun out shooting than I do talking in my office at home. So thank you guys for everything. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.